Hi guys, I'm Jimmy Justice, cage fighter, unlicensed boxer, turned actor, now I'm a movie star. You might have seen some of my movies, Gold Never Lies and Trouble in Paradise. Well, I wouldn't say I'm the hardest man in Britain, but let's face it, in every city, in every town, there's a hard man, okay? But there's always someone harder. But it's the men that are prepared to put their reputations on the line and lose it. These are the men that we look up to. This is Decca Heggie's Hardest Men. Let's go. Here's a quotation I like. It's from the man Decca Heggie. He says, when he goes into his bare knuckle fight, he's only got winning on his mind, and you'll have to kill him to beat him. Okay? Now this man, he's got a big heart, yeah? But the men that he looks up to have also got big hearts and a lot of courage. Okay, so we're going to start with Ian the Machine Freeman. Now, Ian the Machine Freeman is from Durham. He was born in 1966, born on the 11th of October. He was the first English man in the UFC, the first man to beat the former heavyweight UFC champion Frank Mir. We're going to have a look at that fight right now. Take it away.
First grace, the Royal Albert Hall. Now tonight it's mixed martial arts, and here's the tale of the tape. Much older is Ian Freeman, a dozen years. 6'2 is Mir, 237 to Ian Freeman's 5'11, 219. The one thing, though, about the large Frank Mir, he still is cat-like in his
fitness. My name is Ian the Machine Freeman. For those that don't know me, I am a UFC veteran. I am Cage Rage Fighting Championship. I have fought all over the world. I'd like to think I am or was the pioneer of UK MMA.
Okay, next fighter on Decca Heggie Hard Man is Roy Shaw. Roy, pretty boy Shaw. He was undefeated as a professional boxer. He spent many, many years in an institution for the mentally insane, but the system never beat him. Roy Shaw was one hell of a hard man. You'd only have to look in his eyes to see the pain. Now let me tell you, when Roy Shaw fought Lenny McLean, he wasn't in his prime, and if the two would have got together in their prime, it would have been very interesting. I'm sure you all agree. Roy Shaw, those punches that he took of Lenny McLean, unbelievable. Unbelievable how he stood up and got straight back up. That man was one hard man and an inspiration to any fighter. Rest in peace, Roy Shaw.
I was bullied, believe it or not, because I was ever so small. The bullies used to wait for me because I could run fast. And they tried to block off the road and I had to whiz by them, you know, to get away from them. But then one day, after my dad died, I ain't have no more of that. And I whacked him. And over they went. And I thought, cool, it's a gift of God, the power of punch I got. And I whacked him, I'd done about three of them. And they left, from that day onwards, they left me alone. So that's the only way you can beat a bully is do them.
Bang! Straight like that. That's that. If you go like that, they know you're going to hurt them. So he just said, what's the matter? Bang! And over they go. Boom!
Called Ronnie Smith, come over. He said, come and have a Barnet Fair, right? I said, what was I? He said, well, you know, the fair's over there, Barnet, you know, they had bare knuckle fights. What do they? I said, yes, I went over there. I always kept myself fit. And I had three fights over there. I'd done the three of them. I was a professional boxer. They're only little scallywags, roughs, you know, come out and as I was bang, and over they went. I'd done three in the afternoon. So I got $6,000. And they said, yeah. You got that, but you won't be able to beat our top man, Donny Adams. So that's how it all starts.
Next is Lenny McLean. Now, Lenny McLean, the governor, is Decca Heggie's idol. Now, sources tell me that Lenny McLean got beat a good few times in the boxing ring, but he was unbeatable on the cobbles. This is true. That Lenny McLean, in his day, was the governor and would have beaten any man. He had the tenacity of a bulldog. The man was a brute. I've read his book, he's an inspirational bloke. And yeah, he was the governor. Bosh, number one.
I was 20 years known as the hardest man in Britain. Was the best in my time.
Be the best fighter. Be the governor.
My name is Lenny McLean. I'm a bare knuckle fighter. These are my fists in action.
Personally, I hate violence.
When I was a younger man,
in the East End to be a street fighter, you gave respect. And I wanted to be the governor, the best street fighter, so that's what happened.
Lenny is the governor because he was unbeatable.
He was scared of nothing, no man. He was just fearless.
If I lived at St. John's Wood, I'd probably been a college professor. I come from a brutal area where I didn't want to be kicked, so I kicked first.
See, that's how I would do it.
Lenny was a pal of mine, and I've got the utmost respect for him. I think his life is fascinating.
As soon as there was trouble, I would turn in a second from a nice guy to a raving lunatic.
And remember, as you fight, you start getting a reputation. And there'll always be mugs out there looking for a rep.
Right.
So always be on your guard and always keep strong. If you're strong, you'll always be in front of the other guy. Always remember that. Keep strong and fit and hate from there to your ankles. Hate so much.
Bartley Gorman, King of the Gypsies. Now Bartley Gorman won his title from the big just Uriah Burton, who was also a gypsy legend. Now you've got to beat the best to be the best. Bartley Gorman beat the best and he will be known forever as the King of the Gypsies. Rest in peace, Bartley Gorman. You never fought a gorgeous man, but I'm sure I would have got under your skin enough for you to fight me. And you would have beat the crap out of me.
Art ache. A man can have pain in his heart as well as in his body through fighting. A lot of things have happened to me in my life. And as I say, I wouldn't wish it on a dog. Well, anyway, I don't want to pity off anyone. As my father, he had a saying, my back is broad enough to bear it. No one knows me but me. But except God, God knows me. God knows me. When God knows all about me and that's all that matters, I'm not bothered what anybody else thinks about me. Out there, this fighting, it's a stage and I've got to play my part. I was born to play it. I must, that's my destiny. Live or die, that's my destiny.